It's after dinner, in a living room just like yours. Is your television being neglected?
Televisions can be found in living rooms, bedrooms, kitchens, and sometimes even bathrooms, in houses all over the world. But our committed entertainment unit is in danger. Its survival as a separate entity is being threatened by YouTube. Ellie Rennie says that some fear that amateur media spells the end of the public sphere as we know it. Televisions began migrating into homes in the early 1940s. By the 1950s, television was in its golden age and featuring shows like Lone Ranger, The Ed Sullivan Show, and The Tonight Show. The 1990s saw the development of RCA's DirecTV system, as well as satellite systems from the Dish Network, Bell, and StarChoice, giving viewers access to hundreds of channels.
The future seemed bright for televisions around the world. But ever since the popularization of the internet in the mid-1990s, technology gurus have been predicting the decline and eventual demise of broadcasting. In 2006, Google purchased YouTube for $1.65 billion. YouTube's popularity and worth only increased from there. And by December that year, Time magazine nominated you as its person of the year.
In the mass media era, community presses and broadcast outlets were the only significant avenue through which individuals could take part in production. Now, with sites like YouTube, anyone becomes qualified to be a media producer and is likely to have an audience to their productions. Users are learning how to master these different media technologies to bring the flow of media more fully under their control.
So what is it about YouTube? Why are we on YouTube? Why are 200,000 videos a day being uploaded on YouTube? Why are we attracted to it? Why are we not just watching television? What it offers us is something that's different.
It offers us the opportunity to chase after the elusive star persona. People want to be watched, and people want to watch people who are like them.
As Jose Van Dyck observes, the tube in YouTube consciously positions the user in dialogue with the device formerly known as television, saying that the new form of television is made by you. He also states that television, after its convergence with the internet, will gradually disappear as a distinct institutional structure.
It is our duty to save these televisions who have been serving us for over 60 years. So what if YouTube allows you to access almost any kind of visual stimulation at the click of a mouse? And so what if they're free of several minutes of commercials? And so what if anyone can be their own producer? And you can watch your favorite videos over and over, like the one with the pedophile beards and the racist glasses and sex criminal fashion.
Pedophile beards give you that creepy sex face that women simply can't resist. Stop going unnoticed with your boring nice guy look and start scaring the shit out of people. Pedophile beards can be worn on their own or combined with our rapist glasses to create that rapist pedophile look that you've always wanted.
Most people don't realize the seriousness of what our YouTube watching is doing to television. If we don't do something to stop this now, our children will be growing up in a world without television as we know it today. So get off of that computer chair and onto the couch and save the televisions.
Step one, you say we need to talk he walks. You say sit down, it's just talk. He smiles politely back at you. You stare politely right on through. Some sort of